गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 3, टू स्टोरीज अबाउट फ्लाइंग। फर्स्ट यूनिट, हिज फर्स्ट फ्लाइट बाय लाइमवुड फ्लाहर्टी। इन द लास्ट क्लास ऑलरेडी वी हैड डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ द यंग सीगल्स कंडीशन वॉज क्वाइट मिजरेबल, ऑल एलोन ऑन द लेज, नोबडी, नीदर द पेरेंट्स नॉर द siblings came to him. They all were busy in enjoying. His parents were busy in perfecting his siblings in the art of flight, in the art of skimming, and in the art of diving, and no one paid attention towards him, and he was feeling very hungry. And what happens next, this we shall study today. You can see the next paragraph. He stepped slowly out to the brink of the ledge. Because he was feeling hungry, he watched his parents giving training to his siblings, and they paid no attention towards him. He was quite disappointed. Now he wanted to catch their attention. He wanted to get their notice. So what he did, he stepped slowly. Stepped means he moved slowly out to the edge of the corner of the ledge, corner of the cliff, and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing, he closed one eye, then the other, and pretended to be falling asleep. He came to the, moved to the corner of the cliff, and then putting one leg, standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing, he closed one eye, then the other eye, and he pretended. Pretended means he showed to be falling asleep. He showed as if he is sleeping. Still they took no notice of him. Still then, they refers to parents and siblings. Parents seagull and the young seagull's brothers and sister. They paid no attention towards him. They took no notice of him. He saw his two brothers and his sister lying on the plateau, dodging with their heads sunk into their necks. Earlier he had seen that his brothers and sister, they were busy in the art of flight. They were learning the art of flight from their parents. They were learning the how to skim over the waves, how to dive and catch the fish. All these they were learning, and now he saw that his two brothers and his sister lying on the plateau, dodging with their heads. Dodging means taking short sleep, sleeping with their heads sunk into their necks. Generally birds sleep in this way. His father was preening the feathers on his white back. His father, the father seagull, he was preening the feathers. Preening means making an effort to maintain feathers. So his father was busy in preening the feathers on his white back. That means brothers, sister, father, no one looked at him. They all were busy in their own business, their own work. Only his mother was looking at him. Generally it happens, children, mothers are more concerned, much more concerned than anybody else in the family or in the world, we can say, for the children. So it was only his mother who was looking at him. She was standing on a little high hump on the plateau, her white breast thrust forward. The mother seagull, she was standing on a little high hump on the plateau, and his white breast, the front side of mother seagull's body, it was raising forward. Thrust means raised forward. Now and again she tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet, and then scraped each side of her beak on the rock. What she was doing again and again, sometimes she was looking at this young seagull, and again she was tearing a piece of fish that was lying at her feet. And then she scraped. Scraped means rubbed each side of her beak on the rock to sharpen it. So students, actually she was tearing the piece of fish ओके एंड स्क्रैपिंग हर रबिंग हर बीक ऑन द रॉक अगेन एंड अगेन. एक्चुअली दिस इज द वे टू टेम्प्ट दिस यंग सीगल सो दैट ही विल ट्राई टू फ्लाई. इट वॉज अ ट्रिक ऑफ द यंग सीगल्स मदर. सो नाउ एंड अगेन शी टोर एट ए पीस ऑफ फिश दैट ले एट हर फीट एंड देन स्क्रैप्ड इज साइड ऑफ हर बीक ऑन द रॉक. दिस शी वॉज डूइंग टू टेम्प्ट हर चाइल्ड द यंग सीगल. The sight of the foot maddened him because this young seagull had not eaten anything for a long time. For 24 hours he had not eaten anything. So the sight of the food, the sight of this fish maddened him. How he loved to tear food that way, scraping his beak now and again to wet it. Wet means to sharpen. So he thought that he too loved to tear the food in this way, in the same way as his mother was doing. He too liked to scrape his beak now and again to sharpen it. Ga, 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 he cried, begging her to bring him some food. Now, till now he was looking at his mother. He was hopeful that definitely his mother will bring him this piece of fish. But his mother was just tearing the piece of fish and she was rubbing her beak on the rock, but she didn't bring that piece of fish for him. So now he became impatient and he said, ga ga ga, means it is a kind of voice for the seagull. And the seagull cried, begging her to bring him some food. She urged, begging means urging. Her refers to her mother, his mother, to bring him some food. Ga kola, she screamed, begged derisively. Okay, now she screamed. Mother, seagull, she screamed, she shouted back derisively. Derisively means mockingly. It means in a manner showing someone that he or she is stupid. But he kept calling plaintively. Although his mother, she screamed back derisively, she screamed back mockingly, thinking him to be a stupid who is not trying to fly, but still then he kept calling sorrowfully. Plaintively means sorrowfully. And after a minute or so, he uttered a joyful scream. And what's the reason? Why he became so happy? Why he uttered a joyful scream? Because his mother had picked up a piece of the fish and was flying across to him with it. Because his mother, she brought that piece of fish and she was flying across to him with the piece of fish. So he was quite happy. Rest we shall study in the next class, students. Till then, find out the verb forms, find out all the verb and write down all the verb forms. Thank you. Take care of yourself. Have a nice day.